Here we go. Yeah. Here we go. Come on, Kitty.
It's a remarkable moment, huh?
Here we go. The Kia Chef. Good.
Thank
you. Successful. One moment. Way to go, Vay. All your trips to the rinks. Jeremy, success. First year. Got a lady to the juniors.
Thank you.
And Papa.
I only grabbed and five Papa. Glasses, so. The back row's allowed to drink out of the bottle.
The bottle.
Cheers, everybody. Cheers. There you go, Marty. Congratulations, Katie.
Cheers. Congratulations.
First year in Insel, success. Way to go, Jeremy. Many hours out there. Oh, sorry.
Caitlin, you had a great weekend. You surprised everybody.
Yes, I did.
And it makes you quiet now?
A little bit, yeah, a little speechless.
Yeah, 1 year ago you went to the Speed Skating Academy. It was a very good choice, I can say now, eh?
Yeah, I'm very happy Marnix sent me the invitation.
And you never expected this?
No.
The last few days?
No way.
And I heard you had no confidence, and then you had to talk to Jeremy. And Jeremy, how was Caitlin a couple of days before the competition?
She was feeling a little... I think a little nervous, a little unused to the feeling of expecting she can do so well. So, but it's something that I've seen lots of skaters do and go through in my career. So I knew it wasn't a problem. I just had to keep her thinking the right things instead of thinking about getting a medal or something like that. Thinking about what she was going to do in the racing and keep focused on how to skate fast instead of what happens if you skate fast.
She came to the academy, it's good for her, but I think it's also good for the other skaters in the academy that they can learn from Caitlin.
Definitely, it's good for the academy because it's good to show that we can make a good program and develop skaters. It's good for the other skaters to see what happens if you really focus and improve your skating. And it's also good to have a teammate like her to train with.
Congratulations.
Good.
One
successful skater with another one. Yeah. And a former successful skater, right? Cheers. And you're making a comeback. Good.
Yeah. Arthur Was, you won the first medal in the seniors for the academy, right?
Yeah, that was a year ago.
And you had the first medal for the juniors, so there will be coming more.
Exactly.
That's exactly what we're working for.
And she got three this time. Oh, yeah, this is great.
Marnix, exactly what we're working for?
Yeah, this is exactly why we're here and why they suffer all summer, all autumn, all winter. But it's going pretty well, I have to say.
Marnix, this was one of the reasons that you started a couple of years ago with this idea, right?
Yeah, if you look to international speed skating, we need more countries participating. And that especially Switzerland win a medal, it's the first time in history, yeah? Juniors, seniors, whatever. This is special. It's a special moment for us.
What are the goals for the next couple of years?
The next couple of years, the goal is to continue. To keep on continuing getting the support from the ISU. Because as they say in Japan, a tree, you can't pull it out of the ground, you know, you need time for it. And we need time to build a good program. We need time to build a good organization. I think so far we did pretty well, but that's also thanks to our sponsors, you know, because without the sponsors and especially without the help and the support from the ISU, it's impossible for us to have an international development program like we run in Insel. And the goal is to maintain that. And I believe that if we keep on doing good things, skaters won't skate backwards. They will skate better. It's not a problem.
You have a very good skater, Harold Silov from Latvia, who is in the middle 20s. You had Arthur Was, who finally, after a years of racing, get a medal since he was with you. And now Caitlin is a talent. Where do you focus on? The really young ones or all kind of skaters who have problems in their own country?
Yeah, that's correctly. It depends on the country. If you look to Silov's, there is no ice rink, there is no program. He is a great example of a skater who perfectly fit into our development program. But if you look to Caitlin McGregor or Saskia Alusalu, also an example from a skater who was here, or Stefan de Smit from Denmark, we had three skaters here at the Junior Worlds. They need, let's say, a program where they can skate, focus, study, and improve their abilities of being a speed skater. And with Jeremy Waterspoon and Wim den Elsen, we have coaches from top level. We have a superb building in Insel. The environment is excellent. And we are focusing on both seniors and juniors in the last years, because if we have juniors too young, they can't leave their country because of school. But so 17, 18 years, this is what we're focusing on, combined with seniors, because to be a top skater, to become a top skater, you need top training partners to train with. And that's why it's also important to have seniors in the program. And we don't pretend to have the best program in the world, not at all. We just pretend that we are working harder than everyone else, together with the coaches, the staff. You know, we also should thank the person in the kitchen, the person who cleaned the building. It's teamwork. It's speed skating is a solo sport, but it's a team effort.
But you have one of the best juniors in the world right now with Kathleen McGregor, and she skated so well, and you were surprised, and she was good, and it was time to drink champagne.
Yeah, but we weren't surprised because we had the champagne already with us. So she just showed what she's capable to do so, and what Jeremy Waterspoon said, she did it on the right day.